Hello everyone out there in Mr. Arnold's GLN4O class. Today we are going to be reviewing some numeracy and literacy skills that you learned this past week in our Unit 1 work. So what we are going to look at today specifically is graphic text. Now, graphic text has been identified using data from the EQAO as one of the most challenging parts of the literacy test. And graphic text is going to be something that you come upon every single day while reading things like websites, and also something that you are going to be experiencing often in your careers, any career that is indeed. Whenever you look at an instruction manual, whenever you look at a website that you have to fill in forms, whenever you look at a Google form, then you use your graphic text skills. So we'll start today with some key pieces of information that will help you decipher a graphic text and get as much information out of that graphic text as possible. So the first piece that you want to do is, if there are questions based on the graphic text, you want to read those questions first. So the questions in this case are on a Google Doc that you will find at the top of the home page for our class today. That document is called GLN4O Literacy and Numeracy Rules Graphic Text Rules. If you click on that link, it will open a document like this, which you will then make a copy of by simply going to File, then Make a Copy. You can make a copy of this document. So take some time to do that now. Excellent. Let's refer to the questions on this document that you just made a copy of. First of all, what is the main idea of the infographic? Second, list the costs of a skills shortage. Third, which role are employers playing in creating skills gaps? And fourth, how can students and parents help to narrow the skills gap? Excellent. So we've read the questions. Our next step is to scan all the features and make some predictions about their purposes. You can see on the infographic that's been provided for you as a link on the homepage as well, there are many numbers and many headings on this document. So as I skim and scan, I can see that the topic of this document is a skills gap, and there is some threat to Ontario's future. Infographics are great because there's much bold text and there are many graphics on it to help you better figure out what the point of the document is. So there's lots of talk about money. You can see a dollar sign here. If we scroll down, there are percentages. And you can see specifically that skills and the word skilled are referred to over and over again. Which leads us to our next point. As you go through the document, you can make a list of what are called recurring words. Recurring words. So we've gone through the scan, and your next step would be to read all the words on the page and the text features. Once you've done that, you can go back to jot notes. If you don't know what to do for jot notes, a good practice is to type repeated words or keywords. In this case, we know that a major keyword on this is the word skills. Another word is gap. And other keywords may be pieces of information that you don't know already. So if you don't know what the word misalignment means, then you could write the word misalignment down. You can see that there are other keywords. And these keywords are easily identified by the fact that they are in bold type. So you can start to add bold type words, and you can start to add information like numbers. I'll highlight this so you can get a better look at some key pieces of information. Excellent. There may be a legend or a key to help you explain the information in the selection. In this case, there isn't a legend, but the title tells you the main idea. Let's take a look back at the title. The title says, "A looming skills gap threatens Ontario's future." Underneath it, we can see that the main idea is expanded upon, where it says, "Ontario's skills shortages cost the economy up to $24.3 billion in foregone GDP and $3.7 billion in provincial tax revenues annually." If you don't know what foregone GDP means, you can still gain from this statement that Ontario is, and Ontario's economy is set to lose lots of money because of the skills gap. Thanks so much for watching this video, folks, and I hope to see you all again soon.